Today, the Wall Street Journal published an article detailing a survey they did of 66 economists about the prospects of the US economy. The surveyed economists were not too optimistic in their forecasts. In fact, they nearly halved the first quarter growth prognosis from 2% to 1.3%, which would be the weakest growth since 2015. About half of them named the trade wars with China as the biggest risk, and about 90% also believed that the global economic slowdown would affect the US at least somewhat. Now, here it gets juicy. Nearly half of the economists expect the next recession to hit in 2020, and about a third in 2021. So, a new crisis is on the horizon. But the exact point in time when it will happen will be of great importance. Why will it be of great importance? Several reasons. First of all, it might make the difference of who gets blamed for it. If it is in the late stages of a Trump presidency, it might be that Trump gets blamed for it. If it is in the early stages of a new presidency, it might be that the new president gets blamed for it. And if the new president gets blamed for it, it might be that he or she becomes something like a lame duck, even though they possess the Congress and maybe the Senate. Furthermore, this is complicated by the prospects of a Sanders presidency, because I don't think that the markets will be very optimistic about those prospects and will receive them very well. So if it might actually be the case that if those prospects get closer to reality, this might trigger the next recession. And I say that with all the love in the world for Bernie. If that happens, several different scenarios are possible. It might be that Sanders uses this recession in order to underline the volatility of the financial markets and to further his own agenda and to gather support. Or it might be that he gets blamed for it and that his opponents will see it as a further reason for why his proposals aren't viable. Or it might even be that both at the same time happen and that his supporters see it as a reason why he was right all along and his opponents see it as a reason why they have to do everything they can in order to destroy any chances of his presidency succeeding. Furthermore, it is important because it will make a difference in how the elections play out. And it is very, very important how those next elections will play out. It will make a huge difference if the Senate is in the hands of the Republicans or the Democrats, if Trump gets maybe even a second term, if a moderate gains the presidency, or if a progressive gains the presidency. If Trump gets a second term, it will be a disaster, and I have no trust in him whatsoever. I don't think he knows how to handle an economy. I think he is good at marketing, but I don't think he is good at understanding complex relationships. If a moderate gains the presidency, we might see something similar to the Obama years, where Obama pumped a large amount of money into the financial markets, and this helped them recover, and this helped the economy in turn recover, which led to some job creation, but it didn't really do much to bring more wealth into the hands of the bottom 90%. If we see a progressive gaining the presidency, then we might actually see something like a federal jobs guarantee or big businesses breaking up, being broken up, or any kinds of proposals that might even be used in the longer term as demonstrating the viability of socialist measures, even though they are not themselves socialist, but they might be used as measures that lead to more socialist proposals. In another part of the article, it is written that 47.5% said the US has reached full employment, which is not full employment, but the point at which unemployment can't go lower without price and wage pressures, and 44.3% said it is close to it. The official unemployment rate is 3.8%, but the real unemployment rate is 7.3%. Let's just pause here for a moment and think about the fact that we live in a system where 7.3% unemployment counts as full employment. and this at a time where nature is burning. I think some of the people in those 7.3% might be useful in actually doing something against that. Meanwhile, another article of the journal describes investors embracing riskier markets. I won't bore you with the details of which index had what growth, but one quote was noteworthy from Liz Young, the director of market strategy at BNY Mellon Investment Management. It's been risk-seeking behavior on the upside and risk-seeking behavior on the downside. Yeah.